So I couldn't play Overwatch that day.
Indy's contract includes a salary and perks like this spacious apartment, bankrolled by what has become a nearly $1 billion industry. Esports has a huge fan base that pack arenas to watch their favorite players go head to head. It's become a business that pioneers of competitive gaming could not have imagined many decades ago.
Late 70s, early 80s, from this idea of, hey, these video games that are there for fun and entertainment, there's people out there that are real good. Well, how do you prove you're the best in the world? The only way that's going to happen is if the best players in the world get together. So someone had the idea, right? Let's put a prize pool on this. I would say that one of the most notable early examples of this is actually with Quake, where John Carmack, the developer of the game, said, I'm going to put up my personal Ferrari as the prize to the best Quake player that we can find.
And I remember realizing that I was going to win, and I actually noticed the reflection of the Ferrari in my monitor in those last few seconds, and I got really nervous.
After his 1997 victory, Dennis Fong was recognized in the Guinness Book of Records as the world's first professional gamer. When you became the first esports star, as you say, it was almost accidental. It was the right place at the right time. As far as you see it, how has the industry evolved just in the past few decades?
I mean, it's evolved a ton, obviously. When I first started, you know, you're talking about having hundreds of spectators in a room, which was a lot back then. Now you're talking about tens of thousands of spectators, you know, which equivalent to, you know, real sports.
This is what people are interested in, and around the world for that matter.
Steve Cohen is Chief Strategy Officer for AEG, the largest sports ownership group in the world. AEG's portfolio of over 43 professional sports teams boasts several successful esports teams as well, including Indy's team, the LA Valiant.
How do you measure the size of the esports market? How big is it?
900 million to a billion for this year, and expected to go to at least 50% over that by 2020. Here at Staples, we sold out a tournament in less than 15 minutes. You've got public companies like Activision Blizzard or EA Sports. These are multi-billion dollar companies. You start adding all of the values of those companies together, you're talking about hundreds of billions of dollars right there.
Esports is dominated by teenagers and men in their 20s. William Peng, who goes by Double It, is a veteran superstar of this game, League of Legends, at just 25 years old.
The first pro player I've ever, known of was Double It.
What he stands for, how he approaches the game, I think is a really, really intelligent way of going about it. So, I wanted to support him.
You can find a way. You lean on each other, you lean on your experience, and you believe that there's a way. Take a deep breath and strengthen that idea in your mind that you have so that you're decisive, even when it's hard.
Top players like Peng train in state-of-the-art facilities with luxuries other pro athletes have had for years.
Yeah, honestly, it looks so sick, right? It looks so good. This is 1UP Studios, which does all the production, videos, photos. We have war rooms, which are like mini meeting rooms.
Humble guy over here didn't mention that there's a mural of your team.
Yeah.
There's a space in your head featured prominently.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I guess sometimes forget that's the case. It's just pretty cool to have my face just like on the wall.
Yeah, this is our kitchen where we eat every day. Manny cooks 2 meals a day. This is the guy. This is the guy that carries our team. Honestly, Manny carries our team. No one appreciates it, but we like sustain ourselves off Manny's cooking. So.
What are the dietary restrictions of this guy? What are his?
Oh, I need
that. That's it.
Yeah, dude, we love Manny. Everyone loves Manny. Honestly, everyone loves Manny.
I may know how to cook, but it's not that that makes me. It's what makes them. It's what they do to make them better. Later on, it could be number one, but right now, we're going to secure top one.
You know, when sports first started, there was no sports staff at all. It was just five guys who just loved playing games. And, like, I was a part of that where, like, there was no manager, there was no coach. It was just, like, five players on the team. And now I think, like, it's gotten to the point where there's just so much eyes on the scene. There's so much money. There's so much, like, partnerships, opportunities to make money or to, like, collaborate with others. You know, it's like, a fully-fledged business.
Payne's net worth is estimated to be over $1 million. And he has 1 million followers on Twitch, an online gaming platform where users watch others play.
League is a highly competitive game. There are casual players that only play for fun, but League is a game where you can really find a lot of self-improvement every time that you play. Initially, I just loved it as a player, and now I love it as a player. I won't have to win my money for a while, and I'm really grateful for that.
As fortunes rise in top esports players, many parents that would have once discouraged their kids from spending hours playing video games are now cheering them on.
Which guy is yours? He's up there in the second stage on the right.
Oh, good. That was a perfect rotation. Anola went up, DJ got
it. I got it.
I could be late, right?
Like many parents at this local esports competition, Ethan Vuy was eager for his son Connor to excel as a gamer.
I'm not in the video game industry. I have a finance background. Being online has the same social dynamics as any other team sport. If he can be successful playing video games, you wanted to pursue this, I would be very supportive of it.
I do that all the time.
Someone had to be back post on that.
Maybe the piano lessons, all the traditional things that maybe I even did with my oldest child. Maybe it's time for us as a different generation to look at things through their eyes. Connor, you should expect from your teacher. Good luck, Connor, today in the 1v1. Last night, one of our players who won the Fortnite tournament was offered a scholarship.
Wow. You now wanting him to be much better at these games and improve skills.
That is kind of where I'm going now, like understanding that there's like clubs and leagues and things like that, and that maybe there's even support in the college environment for this, that there's scholarships available. So let's see what
Dominic, go for it, Dominic.
Yes.
Jude, you take, I'll take
all. Yeah, play the game right here. This is how you want, right here. Pretty epic land right here.
Elite teenage players are now getting access to the same resources as conventional athletes. Shows has launched competitive esports leagues, and over 100 high schools have developed dedicated esports programs as part of the recently created North American Scholastic Esports Federation. Gamers a decade ago may have been socially isolated, and now training in groups and buying a growing array of careers in the industry.
What do you say to the people who have no clue about what esports are or how big they are?
I think sometimes it's a new world.
There's so many subsidiaries that go into the esports and the gaming industry as a whole.
There's some IT directors, there's some marketers, there's some coaches, there's
What is the biggest misconception about gamers like yourself?
They're just a bunch of nerds or something like that.
Dominic, I'm coming.
I know a lot of people out there have, like, I've heard this around saying, like, oh, it's just like the gamer club, Fortnite, blah, 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 but the truth is, like a lot of people have stated already, it's a really big team sport.
But for the elite few who have their sights set on the arena, the road to stardom can take a heavy toll.
Damn it! That's like the second time!
This is a typical day for Andy and his team at the LA Valiant Training Center. Practice, game review, and more practice. Journalist Richard Lewis has seen the 1 hour due to immense pressure on players.
A 12-hour, 14-hour day is not uncommon, and they do this at least 6 days a week, very often 7, which is why we have all these like terrible issues with burnout. Players kind of getting ground up by 24.
That was scary.
By 24, you're expecting.
Earned a reputation for working long hours. At 18 years old, he started getting to meet more kinds of people at least twice his age.
The last time we talked,
we're doing blue this time.
We're back. We're waiting for that. More to this.
Alright, I'm going for it.
What about the rest?
Jude, you stay in goal. Dominic, you go to midfield. They're not joining. Alright, Jude, you go back post. Dominic, you go midfield.
I play for too long, I'll get pain at the end of the day. Wrist injuries have become prevalent in esports and can end careers before they get started. But for many players, mental health issues are as much a concern as
the player. Alright, you go.
Play in middle school or in high school, there wasn't much stress because you're not competing that hard. But when I went into esports, it's a whole different like level of stress when you're playing against professionals. It's always in the background. You always have that pressure on your shoulders that you have to perform and you have to do really well so that you can win and take everything home.
That was impressive. That was very impressive.
Live in the same house. They live in a gaming house, right?
Literally, lives together, eats together, breathes together, trains together, and there's intense pressure not to get a grab. Yeah, if you're in a house of 6-7 guys and everybody else is deep in their training, you're just gonna bounce for a weekend. You know, I think there's just kind of that social pressure.
I don't even know how I blocked that. But okay.
Some teams like Indies have hired team psychologists to help players deal with the stress.
There's stereotypes that go along with the sport. I grind. I play hour upon hour upon hour upon hour. I put in 12-hour days. And so there's this badge of honor in esports that if I grind more, I'm going to get better. Their brains are constantly churning. You can see the stress in their face and in their eyes. And so what we're trying to do is avoid that burn. Avoid that 2-year career that the player plays and makes a decent amount of money for those 2 years. But then goes from that to nothing.
It seems as though
you are so lucky I got gold.
Is there anything to be done about that?
I don't know if there's a real answer to that. Yeah, I think it's set up.
Yes. Let's go.
Remember that this is just the first generations coming up.
The unknown seem to be the biggest hurdle and throw that plan ahead? What are some of the other challenges?
I got this.
The danger comes when you don't do it in a responsible and sustainable way.
I got gold.
And I get worried about hot money just screwing this up.
Yep.
That's what I worry about.
The money that got screwed in now.
It's almost centered. It's going to be centered.
Miss out and get one slice of that.
And I got
exposed. Football, American football. You've got the NFL, the teams, you've got the players, and the players have their agents. For esports, which entity has the real and true power?
So let's pause it here. Get one light for us, Eli, real quick.
No.
I'm taking a second to pause. We're actually going to put on their game on the screen to watch right now, real quick.
We're still ahead, though.
I have a lot.
Yeah, I know. But what we need to do is the first second. All right.
I'll stay
going. All right, Dominic, you go. I'm going midfield.
This is going to be super fun. But let's rally on that real quick, just because, and then we'll jump back into our lesson. Let's get into, you guys can follow along on,
We can't get out of the front.
No. We're gonna stop that one, get it to it. Hold on.
I'm getting all
there
the
will
Discord
be. I mean, we don't, they don't want it.
You know what? What were you doing? Oh, yeah.
Dominic, I'm switching for you.
What the heck?
Someone was doing the turtle. Yes.
Wait, you know what? I need defense.
I'm fixing some audio stuff. Hold on, guys. They didn't have audio yet. We'll wait for the next kickoff here. We're going to test.
Let's go.
Wait, we've all scored a goal now.
Yeah, we all scored a goal. Good job. We got to keep it up, though.
I'm in the lead because of that epic save.
Can't do that. I think you can.
I don't think my ping is over the
middle. I got it.
Alright, I got goal.
I got left corner, so I got it. I got it.
I know he was going to midfield.
Yeah. I'll turn up the volume next game. I had to do some adjustments. This is what we're going to do tomorrow. Try it. Let's go, Raptors.
Come on.
Yes.
5 seconds
away. It is.
I'm gone. Yeah, bye. One more game.